Good morning children. In previous class we solved the problems by using Lenz formula. Today we will solve some more problems by using Lenz makeup formula. Lenz makeup formula is 1 by f equal to n minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2, where r1 and r2 are the radii of curvature, n is refractive index and f is focal length. Let's see what is the question. First question, what is the focal length of a double concave lens kept in air with two spherical surfaces of radii, r1 is 30 cm and r2 is 60 cm. Take refractive index of lens as n equal to 1 minus 5. Here one question he has given, he is talking about lens, but how to understand that whether we should use Lenz formula or Lenz maker formula. He mentioned the word lens refractive index. Whenever in the question if he mentioned refractive index and radii of curvature, not only radius, two radius he mentions, so that means we need to use Lenz maker formula. Am I clear children? Now here he has given r1 and r2 value and n value he has given. We need to find f. But before solving the question, we need to do the sign convention. You know how to do the sign convention. Now for concave lens, r1 is negative and r2 is positive. Always remember children, for concave lens, r value we change. Value means sign we will change. R2 we will keep as it is. That's why r1 is 30 he has given. We are taking minus 30. R2 is 60. Clear children? Now Lenz maker formula is 1 by f equal to n minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Clear? N value here he has given. We are substituting that 1.5 minus 1 as it is divided into 1 by r1 is 30 minus 30 minus 1 by 60. Clear children? 1.5 minus 1 is nothing but 0.5. See, when we subtract 1.5 minus 1 means 1.0. We will get 0.5. See, 0.5. Then minus 30 he has given. That minus we are sending up. That become minus 1 by 30 minus 1 by 60. This 30 and 60 LCM we have to take because it is in fraction. So 30 and 60 LCM we are taking. 30 once 30, 32 60. Then 2 is there, 2 ones 2, both ones we got, that means we should stop and we should multiply these numbers, 30 into 2, 32, 60. So 60 is the LCM, this 60 we need to divide by this first fraction denominator 30. We are dividing here 30 to 60, this 2 we need to multiply with numerator minus 1 into 2 minus, again this 60 we need to divide with this denominator 60, 61, 60. So this 1 we need to multiply with numerator, clear children? And this 0.5, I am writing in fraction 5 by 10 because after decimal 1 digit is there means we should divide by 10. Am I clear children? So this 1, 5 by 10 as it is into 1 into 2, 2 minus 1 into 1, 1. So minus 2 minus 1, minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3. So 5 by 10 into minus 3 by 60. Am I clear children? So 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 10, 3 1 is 3. 3 2 6 3 0 0. So what is remaining? 1 into 1 minus, because here minus is there, so minus 1 into 1, then divided by 2 into 20. Clear? So 1 by f equal to 1 1 is 1, 2 20 is 40. Clear children? 1 by f equal to minus 1 by 40. Take the reciprocal. 1 by f we are taking the reverse, f by 1, and 1 by 40 we are taking again reverse, 40 by 1. So f will get minus 40 centimeter. We got the f value and we got minus. This minus indicates that the lens is divergent. Divergent is nothing but children, concave lens. Clear? So focal length of a double concave lens is 40 centimeter. Am I clear children? Let's see, we will solve one more problem. A double convex lens. Just now we solved based on concave, now we are taking convex lens. A double convex lens has two surfaces of equal radii and refractive index n is equal to 1.5. Find the focal length. Again here he mentioned refractive index, that means we should use lens maker formula. And he mentioned the two surfaces of equal radii, that means radius of curvatures are equal. So let's suppose r1 and r2 both are equal, he mentioned, that we are taking as r, something we should take because the both are unknown, with unknown we can't do anything. So we are supposing r1 and r2 both are equal, so that is equal to 1 r. Clear children? And refractive index he has given. Again for convex lens, how to do sign convention? For convex lens, r1 is positive and r2 is negative. Clear children? For concave we took r1 negative and r2 positive. For convex we will do r1 positive and r2 negative. Clear children? R1 is r, Just now we suppose an R2 also R, but we need to change, so minus R we are taking. Now by using Lenz maker formula, 1 by F equal to N minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. That is equal to N value we have 1.5, we are writing 1.5 minus 1 into 1 by R1 is R minus 1 by R2 also R, but minus R. Clear children? This minus multiply, you will get plus. So 1.5 minus 1 is 0.5. Just now I have shown you 1.5 minus 1 only means 1.0. 5 minus 0, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. Sorry, 5 minus 0 is 5. 5 minus 0 is 5. 1 minus 1 is 0. So 0.5. That is into 1 by R as it is. Minus into minus plus 1 by R. Clear children? See, both denominators are same. So directly we can add the numerator. 0.5 we can write 5 by 10, 1 plus 1, as I told you just now, both denominators are same, is directly we are adding the numerator 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 by R, 5 by 10 into 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 by R, clear children, 5 1's 5, 5 2's 10, 2 1's 2, 2 1's 2, so 1 by F equal to 1 by R, take the reciprocal, reverse it, so F equal to R. We got positive here, so that means plus indicates that the lens is convergent. Convergent is nothing but convex lens. Clear children? So focal length is nothing but radius of curvature, equal to the radius of curvature which he did not give. Clear children? Now today's your homework is, the radii of curvatures of a double convex lens are 15 cm and 30 cm. That means R1 is 15, R2 is 30. And its refractive index is 1.5. Calculate its focal length, you will get 20 cm. Your answer should be 20 cm. You calculate and you will get. Second question, a double concave lens with refractive index n is 1.5 is kept in the air. Its two spherical surfaces have radii R1 equal to 20 cm, R2 equal to 40 cm. Find the focal length of the lens. Clear children? So F value will get minus 80 by 3. Otherwise, if you want to convert into decimal, you will get minus 26.667. Clear children?